All right, hey guys, I think I'm live on both. I'm not sure because I don't have my technical crew here today with me. Let me rephrase that. I'm down two people today on my technical crew, and I'm not very computer savvy, so I don't know. I hope that we're live. Anyways, happy Thursday, I think. I'm sorry I look gross and sweaty because I'm doing something a little bit different today. Instead of doing a workout with you guys and posting a workout, I'm showing you kind of what I do for accessory work. And these trash cans, every time. Thank you, trash people, but you always have to come at 12:30. Yes? Okay. All right, I hope you can hear me. Anyways, so I've already worked out today. I did my strength work today. Typically, the flow of my workout goes. This is funny. A typical workout day for me usually goes strength portion. So today I did split jerk. I started off with bench, at 720. Actually, because I'm I'm sorry. I can't get it together today. Anyways, I'm doing a cycle. I'm doing a squat cycle, so with that, I'm also working in deadlifts and bench. So I started out with a set of 20 on my bench, and then I moved into my strength portion for today, which I did split jerk today, which, by the way, I got a PR, and I'm really excited about. And I do honestly think that it's because I've been implementing some extra bro lifting lately, and so it's kind of ironic that I wanted to bring y'all in on my bro sesh today, since I got a PR, and it could be highly likely that it's because I've been doing some more free weights and targeting specific areas. So I'm pretty pumped about that. I got 185 today, woohoo, and it didn't look terrible. Could it look better? Absolutely, but it did look terrible. So. Anyways, I did the strength portion of my workout, and then I did a Metcon, which was running with a weight vest. I did some kettlebell swings and handstand push-ups, and strict pull-ups. So, my arms are already taxed. However, most of our accessory stuff today is arms and shoulders, and so this should be interesting. I do like a good burnout at the end of the day. Whenever I do accessory work, which I try to implement almost every day that I work out, it is at the end of my workouts. So that's why I wanted to bring you guys in today so you can see what that looks like. I'm not going to do as many sets as what I would normally do for the sake of time because I honestly don't think that you guys want to sit here for that long. But I will say that the longer that I'm doing more accessory work, the quicker that I get at it. At first I was like, because somebody recommended some different movements and stuff to me, and I was like, I don't have time for this. Like, it takes a really long time to go from one movement to the next. So a couple things I was doing wrong. A, I wasn't as familiar with the movements. And so becoming more familiar with the movements really helps that you know exactly what it is that you're going into. And then B, I was taking entirely too long in between sets because I wanted to rest, but it kind of defeats the purpose. And so you want to do one set and then take a short break. It's like one-to-one. However long it takes you to do the set, take a break, go back, hit up the same thing again, okay? So our structure for today, and I'll put this in later on after this because I just didn't do it before because I honestly didn't know until I looked at my workout for the day what it was I was going to be doing. But we're going to do dumbbell bench press, we're going to do incline dumbbell bench press, we're going to do a seated press, and then some lat raises. And then after that, I do want to do a little bit of legs and core, and so we're going to do some dumbbell goblet squats, stiff leg, dumbbell deadlifts, and then rear lunges with the band with dumbbells. So, I hope you brought your dumbbells today. It's another drug. I hope you brought your dumbbells today. I will go into really quick why I love dumbbells. I actually wrote a small article about this that I'm going to put on my website. I'm going to get my website up and live, which I'm pretty excited about. Hopefully it's coming soon. But I do love a good set of dumbbells for multiple reasons. Number one, they're fairly cheap, they store easily, and so you can buy multiple pairs and have a lot of different weights to work with. In addition to that, because you're having to, they're not as stable as like a connecting bar, for instance, you are utilizing, you're having to balance more, and therefore you're having to use more core strength, and so I really do like that. In addition to that, you can use them for bro lifting. You can go heavy, you can go light, and like I said before, all this bro lifting, not only aesthetically do I like what it does for one's body, because you're able to really hone in on like those small muscles that you don't really hit during your major muscle groups that you're working whenever you're doing some of the other like lifts and stuff. I just totally forgot where I was going with that. Oh my gosh. Safe whenever you're moving around your dumbbells. You don't want to jerk them around on your shoulder or anything. Ugh. All right, so sets of six, three sets. Work one, rest one. Oh, I'm a little stiff from working out. Next, we're gonna change it to an incline. The reason why I like doing incline, and I like decline too, honestly, but I have to kind of rig it in order to get this bench into a decline position. But you're just able to hit like different points within the shoulder and the chest than you would just because of gravity and the nature by which direction it is that you're lifting. So. I just want a slight incline, nothing too crazy. And that changes it just enough to where you can feel the difference. And I'm gonna go down in weight too because I don't want 30s pulling on my shoulder in that direction. All right, so same thing. We're gonna do 3 sets of 6 with this, but I would typically do 5. Start to see that pump. That's what I like. Alright, next we're going to go to a seated press. You can call this military press, strict press, whatever you want to call it. Basically, you're going from this position overhead. I'm going to do it in a seated position. You don't want to use your legs. You don't want to dip and drive. That's going to be for a push press. Completely different movement. We won't be doing a strict press today. Also, take your time. It doesn't have to be rushed. Make sure you have good form. You don't want to compromise form for the sake of upping your weights. Nobody cares how much weight you can do. Actually, yeah, some people do, still. Don't compromise your form. Alright, one more set. Ugh. more sets. All right. Next, I'm doing lateral raises. This is something you really don't want to go heavy with. Just the impact that it can have on your shoulders. And because I do lighter weight, I tend to go a little higher in reps. So for this, I would change it up and do 5 sets of 15. Okay, you may think that you're doing super light weights in the beginning, but that's fine, because I guarantee you, whenever you start hitting like 10 and up, you're definitely gonna feel a burn, okay? So I'm gonna start off with 5s, see how that feels, and decide if I wanna go from there. Same thing, nice tight core, good center, shoulders back and down, don't keep them up here. All right, we're just gonna go out to a T. Not up here, we don't wanna overextend. Right there, every time. Squeeze at the top. Oh. I always feel so tired after this. Alright. Oh. That was maybe a little bit. I'm not going to say light, but I feel like I can do more. So I'm adding 2.5. That's only like 7.5 pounds. I'm pretty sure that those weight colors, if you go and buy them, would be like hot pink. You know what I'm talking about if you have some of those weights. Alright. Let's go again. But we're shortening it. In addition to that, what I did not do is going to be the front raise with those. So it's the same thing, except just out to the front. So if I was not live, then I would definitely add those puppies in as well. All right, let's move on to legs. All right. Whenever you're doing stuff like this, you have all different kinds of options. If you want to do like, if you want to do sets of 20, 18, 16, go through all the movements, do one arm at a time, then do the other arm, you can do that. If you want to work through one set and then move on to the next set, you can do that. Just play with it. There's tons of stuff out there where you can learn how and what to do, and if you have any questions, ask me. All right, first one's going to be a dumbbell goblet squat. Y'all know what these are because I'm sure you've been doing a ton of them at home. Since everybody's been home lately, we're gonna do 4 Actually, we'll lower it to three. We're gonna do three sets of eight. I wanna do a little heavier on this just because I know my legs can handle a little bit heavier load. But whenever I say heavy though, it's probably, I'm gonna do 35. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do, is 35. One other reason why I like a goblet squat so much is because it forces you to get in that front wrap position to where you're having to stabilize your core in order to keep your chest upright. And anytime that I can use my core even more to help stabilize and to help execute movements, then you're just better off. So, and tuck that puppy in. Do eight good squats. For that amount, I should probably be doing heavier weight, but at this point I'm just kind of toning, so I'm good with that. Alright, let's go again. Drag the dumbbells down on deadlift, keeping them in as close to my legs as I can. I'm getting tired. All right, let's go in for eight. Notice I go down slower, and then I want to squeeze those glutes, pop back up to the top quick. Slow, 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 slow. Up. Slow, 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 slow. Let's go.
on those. Lastly, for the legs, we're going to do a rear lunge with a band. Resistance bands. One of the best, cheapest, most effective, most versatile pieces of equipment you can get in the gym, and most humbling, I'll tell you that much. Because I look at a band and I'm like, I can completely do this, and then I start doing it halfway through, I'm like, shoot, I don't know that I can do this. So, for this one, and then I'm going to wrap it around my knee, okay, the back of my leg essentially, okay? I want it pulling me forward. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to step back and lunge, and what this does is it helps keep that knee in track, pulling forward and in alignment, okay? So I'm going to grab an ab mat, touch my leg to the back, stand back up, and I'm going to hold weights, and these are my lunges, okay? Legs. Same thing. All right, we got two more sets each side. Make sure you keep your chest up. Shoulders back. By the way, I see those comments and stuff, and I've got to get better at somehow integrating like conversation during workout by seeing them, responding to them. I'm not sure how to do that yet. All right. I feel it in my glutes too. Thank you.